Hi guys, Scott from Scott's Bass Lessons here again. This week I'm going to be talking about right and left hand positioning. I see so many players on TV and you know gigs and things like that, and their right and left hand positioning is terrible, and in all honesty they're going to end up injured if they don't sort it out with things like RSI, repetitive strain injury and things like that. So let's talk about the right hand first, and first of all I should say you need your bass at the right height to start with, otherwise you're going to be causing problems straight from the off. So you need the foundations to be right, which is the height of your bass. So I've done a tutorial on strap height, how high you should have your bass. Check it out if you haven't, okay? Save yourself from injury, check it out if you haven't. Then come back here and we'll talk about left and right hand positioning. Sorry, my dog's wandering around here. So, right hand first, okay? Now, I'm sure you've seen people with their bass is too high and their arms like this, sorry for the squeaky chair, their arms playing like this kind of thing, okay? Now, although they're doing that, this, okay, is not good. You're going to give yourself an injury if you keep on doing this. The tendons are going to go over, there's a small bone in the wrist. And just imagine if the tendons are going over that bone like this, okay? And then you're moving your fingers, so they're rubbing back and forward over this bone, okay, in your wrist. Is that going to give you problems? You're damn right it is. So what you need to do is you need to straighten the wrist out, okay? You need to straighten the wrist out. He's very restless today, George, aren't you? So you need to straighten the wrist out, so when you move the fingers, the tendons in the wrist have got a freer movement through the bones, okay? So what you need to do is just have your hand down here and just place it. You can I like to put it on the pickup because I like to play over the pickup. And just make sure that you can have a slight bend in your wrist, okay? I used to try and play with it completely straight. The guy called Gary Willis who plays with it is completely straight like that, but I did find it really uncomfortable. So I like to have a slight bend in the wrist, more like this kind of thing, okay? But it's nice and free, it's not this, it's this. Slight bend, okay? Just a slight bend. Now, when it comes to the left hand, this is also where people go wrong all the time, okay? With the left hand, just put your hand down by your side and then just lift it up. I just want you to, if you've got your bass at the right height, you're going to be, you know, getting there a lot easier than if you haven't. So get your hand, left hand or right hand if you're left-handed, down by your side and simply lift it up really relaxed and put it on the fretboard. Now notice that there's a gap, a nice gap between the body and the side of my arm. It's not, which is, this is, happens a lot, tucked in like this, okay? Do not, if I just go like this with my arm, I'm not going like this, which is what so many people do. They just tuck it in like this. And the thumb comes over the top and this hand's like this. Okay, what you want to do is lift it up, nice gap between here. You know, I've probably got about this much, 3 inches. It's nice and relaxed, my arm, not tense, not tucked in here, okay, just nice and relaxed. And the hand, if I come around here, it's almost strong. I'm going to take my glove off. It's almost straight. I know a load of people are going to email in saying, what's the glove for? It's because I've been injured in the past, but it's not really to do with positioning or anything like that. So my arm's almost straight, okay, it's almost straight. It's not like this. Keep away from that. Bad news, man. You just want it nice and straight. So, one more thing I should talk about as well. Your thumb, okay? So many people play with it over the top of the neck like that. Now, the problem is with this, if your thumb's over the top, look what your hand's doing, okay? It's not like a sweeping motion like you want it. It's crunched up like this, and again, you're not going to be able to do the wide stretches. I just can't do it. You know, your hand's so restricted when you've got this part of your hand, your palm and your thumb on the neck like this. It's just going to restrict you so much. So what I try and do is classical guitar technique, and I try and have my thumb just in the middle of the neck all the time. Okay, it just runs up and down. So hopefully if you follow these guidelines, it's going to keep you a lot, you know, healthier, your body, your tendons, you know, all your muscles and things, so much healthier than if you were crunched up into weird positions. And ultimately, it's going to help you play bass a lot better, and it's going to make you or help you progress a lot faster as well. So really take these tips on board and try and implement them into your playing. If you haven't seen my website before, it's scottsbasslessons.com. It is full of great exercises, licks, techniques, all this kind of thing. Everything bass, basically. So go check it out, and it's all for free. And there's other things available there too. Other than that, I'll see you soon. Take it easy and get in the shed.